nation will enter here. People who struggle with addictions, well, I've come to bring you hope and if, and when the whole world turns against you, my child, fear not, and sing to them alleluia, 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 I am free. So what's the world if you have everything, but you lose yourself in it? Pray for fire to burn within you and keep your flame lit. God will take care of it. And when lightning goes to strike you, turn and face it.
November 9th, 1531, Juan Diego walks along the western side of Tepeyac Hill on his way to catechism at a Franciscan mission just north of Mexico City.
Es el sábado, 13 caña, a punto de celebrarse el solsticio de invierno. Él ahí ve la transformación de todo este cerro del Tepeyac, que de por sí era un cerro pedregoso, polvoso, salitroso, signo de muerte donde no crecía la vida, ahora está lleno de la vida divina, y dentro de todo esto se hace el silencio. Se hace el silencio para escuchar lo primero que sale de la boca de la Virgen Santísima. Lo primero que sale, lo primero que dice la Virgen de Guadalupe es el nombre del laico indígena, Masegual, Juanito. Juan Diegotzin, Juanito, Juan Dieguito.
According to the account in the Nican Mapoa, the woman identifies herself as the mother of the true God and asks that a sacred house be constructed in her honor on Tepeyac Hill. She asks Juan Diego to bring this message to Bishop Zumarraga.
Pues bien, Juan Diego va con el obispo para pedir que se pudiera construir esta casita sagrada. Cuando llega el obispo, son los criados los que lo dejan afuera horas, hasta que por fin puede llegar ante el obispo, le dice todo lo que... Y obviamente el obispo en ese momento, en su responsabilidad apostólica, pues no podía simplemente dar crédito a una persona que llegara y simplemente le dijera que vio a la Virgen y que está hablando con ella.
No te cuino, ay, no pa' acá, no más igual en otra. En Matlotolsin.
Juan Diego returns to Tepeyacil empty-handed. The woman asks him to return to Bishop Zumárraga with the same message. He obeys, and this time the bishop asks for a sign.
Juan Diego está allá con la Virgen, le dice que lo recibió el obispo y que necesita una señal. La Virgen le dice, ven mañana lunes y yo te doy la señal.
On Monday, Juan Diego fails to show up. His uncle Bernardino is gravely ill, facing death. He asks Juan Diego to find a priest to administer last rites. On December 12, 1531, Juan Diego sets out towards Tlatelolco to find a priest for his uncle.
El 12 de diciembre, Juan Diego capta que hace muchísimo frío, helaba, toma una tilma que se anuda al cuello y se envuelve el cuerpo con ello. Por eso es larga, porque tiene que envolverse con la tilma.
In a hurry, Juan Diego tries to avoid meeting the Virgin. He goes around Tepeyacil, but the woman comes down from the top of the hill and cuts him off. Juan Diego explains why he's in a hurry, but the woman tells him to have no more fear, that she holds him in the fold of her mantle and in the cradle of her arms, and she assures him that his uncle is well.
La Virgen de Guadalupe, cuando le está diciendo a Juan Diego que su tío ya sanó, en ese mismo momento ella se aparece en Tulpetlac, en la casa de Juan Diego, donde se encuentra postrado por la enfermedad Juan Bernardino. Es ahí donde ella entrega su nombre completo. A Juan Bernardino le dice, yo soy la perfecta siempre Virgen Santa María de Guadalupe.
Juan Diego asks her to honor him by letting him be her messenger. Our Lady of Guadalupe now instructs him to climb to the top of Tepeyacil and gather up in his tilma all the flowers he finds. Upon reaching the summit, Juan Diego is amazed to find extraordinary flowers in full bloom. These flowers would be the sign for the bishop.
Llega a la casa de Fray Juan de Zumárraga, pasa, Juan Diego le explica todo lo que aconteció, todo lo que sucedió y le da las rosas, las flores, hazme el favor de recibirlas, le dice Juan Diego. Y en ese momento, delante del obispo, se plasma la imagen de la Virgen de Guadalupe en la tilma de Juan Diego.
This remarkable image, inexplicable in its style, luminous colors and imagery, would change the course of history for the entire continent.
To forget, I'll tie your love around my neck. I'll write your words upon my heart. Lord, I won't forget how good you are.
I'll dwell upon your faithfulness. I'll rest within your promises. And when I'm walking through the dark, Lord, I won't forget how good you are. I will trust, I will trust you, I will trust you, Lord, with all my heart, and I won't forget how good you are, no, I won't forget how good you are. You gave me everything I have, is in your hands. When what I fear is closing in, Lord, your faithfulness will never end. Your faithfulness will never end. I will trust.
our brothers on the road. We are here to help each other walk the mile and bear the load. I will be.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Saint Timothy,
pray for us.
Saint Elizabeth,
pray for us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Ora pro nobis. Juan Diego, Catherine Drexel, Saint Francis, Saint Lucy, ora pro nobis. Saint Nicholas,
pray for us.
Saint Cecilia,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Gabriel,
pray for us.
Ora pro nobis. Ora pro nobis.
Thank you.